basketball became an official Olympic sport, 1936, Berlin, played outdoors on sand and clay, and this USA team defeated Canada 19-8 for the gold medal, setting off a win streak that features, over the years, so many great players, like Oscar Robertson, 1960, Rome, and Michael Jordan, 1984, Los Angeles, leading one of the greatest Olympic teams. Now 1988, and those who aspire to be Olympians, including David Robinson, trying to regain his form after 2 years in the Navy. Last season's Collegiate Player of the Year, Danny Manning, a consensus All-American at Kansas, leading the Jayhawks to the NCAA title. And the big Tar Heel, J.R. Reed, trying to bang his way onto this 1988 U.S. Olympic team. 107 players invited, 17 remain. For Coach John Thompson to start the final molding process, which includes a series of games against NBA select all-stars. Winning the gold, nothing quite like it. 1984, a song and dance. 1988 will be harder, which is why the next 26 days will be so tough for the U.S. Olympic basketball team. The Civic Center in Providence, Rhode Island, for this first of eight games between the candidates for the U.S. Olympic basketball team, 17 of them, that by September 2nd will be trimmed to 12. They will play eight times against NBA select all-stars. And the personnel on these NBA teams probably will change some as they go through their particular schedule and the individual schedule some of them have, because a lot of them are involved in a charity event today out in Los Angeles, California. We started out with 107 athletes trying out for spots on this Olympic team under John Thompson. Let's turn to Dick Vitale now, who has literally watched all these young people grow up through high school and college, and give me your quick assessment of what John Thompson has to work with.
Keith, when we look at the makeup and the composition of this basketball team, I see some great athletes, a lot of quickness up front. I don't see the physical bruising kind of players. But we look at Danny Manning, he's Mr. Versatility. David Robinson, will he become the Admiral or will he be soft? That's a big question mark. Charles Smith, a dominant player from out of Pittsburgh, 6'10", a very versatile player. Stacey King, and then we have the high school kid, Alonzo Mourning. The question mark I have, Keith, perimeter play, backcourt play. What kind of point guard play will we get? And can we shoot the three-point shot? Because in international basketball, the three-point shot is prevalent.
One of the problems that you and I both know they're going to have because of what Oscar Schmidt did to the U.S. team in the Pan Am Games is who's going to guard the three-point shot.
Well, that's important. John Thompson's made a real statement about that, that he wants to find some perimeter defensive people to shut down the trifecta, the three-point shot. Guys like Stacey Augmon out of the University of Nevada, Las Vegas, is an outstanding defensive player, and will have a shot because of that. I still say we have to find point guard play, and that answer will be here. Keith, I'll tell you what, despite all those questions, the chances of us losing the gold medal in Seoul, forget about it. I have a better chance of replacing Tom Cruise as the new sex symbol in Hollywood than us losing the gold medal.
We've also got golf for you today. The final round of the U.S. Senior Men's Open. Jack Whitaker brings us up to date on that. All right, Jack, we'll be looking for that pressure-packed event coming up right after our basketball game. Speaking of people under pressure, John Thompson, Georgetown. He is the Olympic coach. He has some pressure.
What are you opening anyway?
Coca-Cola presents the U.S. Olympic... We're ready to go with the first of eight games between NBA select stars against the U.S. Olympic team candidates. John Thompson on the right, the U.S. Olympic coach out of Georgetown, Jimmy Rogers, who succeeds Casey Jones as coach of the Boston Celtics, handling the NBA team. And the starting lineups, you have Dan Marley, Danny Manning, Charles D. Smith out of Pittsburgh, Charles Smith out of Georgetown as a guard, Hersey Hawkins. Son of Bradley will be the other guard. NBA, Rodney McRae, Terry Cummings, Patrick Ewing, Michael Adams, who played in this area at Boston College, and Rodney McRae, of course, out of Louisville, Patrick from Georgetown, Chris Mullen, number 20, from St. John. So that's the starting unit for the NBA Select All-Stars. Joe Forte, and it's Marley to the basket, and the Olympians take the lead, 2-0. And Jesse Thompson of the NBA, 8-year veteran, are the officials for today's ball game. And we get a turnover in backcourt. Now, when you have a turnover in backcourt, the official does not have to handle the ball. And when you get in international competition, you better be alert, because that thing will come whistling up court before you can take a breath.
That's really important as part of the transition game, Keith. We saw a slam jam by Dan Marley, and he's a name that's really played exceptionally well and doesn't have the big reputation out of college.
Terry Cummins spoils Marley's effort there. Marley coming out of Central Michigan. Here's Chris Mullins. His shot is blocked, and the Olympians are running. The shot was blocked by number 22 for the Olympians, Hersey Hawkins. Here's Marley penetrating inside. Three-point shot by Smith of Georgetown. No. Rebound Ewing.
That's the shot they're looking for. They want Charles Smith to shoot that trifecta from at the top of the key.
Mullen.
He can shoot it. He can flat out shoot it. A velvet touch. Player of the year, 1985. Had really a strong recovery this year after going to alcohol rehabilitation in January.
That was Charles D. Smith of Pittsburgh putting it in. Little Michael Adams so quick and fumbles it away inside, and the Olympians have it. And moving in a hurry with it is Charles Smith, the fourth from Georgetown. Marley for three. No, air ball. Ewing standing there catches it.
He's really a good shooter. He's got to be a little tight right now. That's one of his strong assets, Marley, shooting the ball. He'll be going to Phoenix, an NBA first-round draft choice.
The thing to watch here is the quickness of the Olympians, the tenacity. Defense, tenacious defense, and constant pursuit is something that John Thompson demands of his players, and it's something that this U.S. Olympic basketball team is going to have to carry into the games if they want to win it.
Keith, that's a good analogy. As we take a look at John Thompson, I call him the champ. He has that power draped on his back. But they will play very tenacious defense and utilize their defense as part of their offense, trying to get scores in transition. That's the great asset of the United States players versus a lot of the international players who are very mechanical, as Cummings misses the first free throw.
Danny Manning on that foul for Cummings. Terry at the line. They are playing sort of a combination of rules in a way. They're playing the international markings on the floor. It's 9 inches farther out than the collegians do for their three-point play, but a little bit short of what the NBA has. That is Marley, Dan Marley, who brings a big body and dogged determination to the court. That is a foul whistled on Rodney McRae, and Danny Manning, who's wearing number 13, will go to the foul line.
He's such a versatile player. He can play anywhere along the baseline. I think his natural position, as we look at Danny Manning here, is basically as a number three man, a small forward. They get the entry down inside. Manning trying to lock in a box. McRae playing behind him. Turns, gets fouled. McRae, normally a good defender, playing with the Houston Rockets, and he's been part of some rumors that he might be traded.
Well, they're going to have something to talk about in the offseason.
Well, I'll tell you one thing. As we look at Danny Manning, what a finish, Keith, he had last year, winning that national championship for Larry Brown in Kansas. Unbelievable miracle job.
Look out. Michael banging into the table right here in front of us. That's a backcourt foul. The foul is called on Hawkins, and the NBA will bring it in. Remember now, the official doesn't have to handle it. Neither one of these teams have adjusted to that yet. But somewhere along the way today, we may well see it. Inside, good play, Ewing, and his basket is made, and no foul call. They're going to let this game play a little looser than you would expect if you're a collegiate basketball fan, even looser than you would expect for NBA, because I'll tell you right now, they play more physical basketball in international competition than they do anywhere in this country.
Well, you saw that in 1984 doing the games on ABC. We dominated in 84, but remember, the USSR wasn't there. This has got to be our asset. Run the ball up the court, play with great athletic ability.
Well, the NBA guys just got to town yesterday. If you want the truth of it, they've had very little time to get themselves organized, but they do have the capacity to go in there. You got Big Kevin Duckworth on this NBA roster. He may go inside if we see David Robinson today and whack him around a little bit, because you must be physical. But here is a guy right here who is physical. gets the basket, gets the foul, and will go to the line.
They're going to like Marley out in Phoenix. I'll tell you one thing, Keith. He's a member of the old school of players. Just plays with tremendous tenacity. We watch him in transition. An excellent bounce pass. Now, here's Marley running the court. Strong body. He's had a lot of injuries. Fouled across the back by Cummings. But what a job he has done in his postseason play after graduating from Central Michigan. There's the foul across the shoulder.
Vernell Coles of Virginia Tech comes into the ball game at guard. David Robinson comes in. Danny Manning goes out, and so does Charles Smith.
He was the MVP over in Portsmouth, Virginia, in an all-star competition featuring a lot of potential NBA players. Played for a good friend of mine, Charlie Coles, former outstanding high school coach in Saginaw and now coaching at Central Michigan.
11-5 for the Olympians. That shot inside misses. And it's out of bounds back there, so they'll take it on the back line.
Hey, partner, you made a good point about the fact that these players have just been assembled overnight, the NBA people, and coming out here trying to put a structured game against these people who have been practicing. It's very difficult, especially in transition, getting back to stop the running game.
Chris Mullen out in front with it. Harry Cummings against Charles Smith of Pittsburgh won't go down. The rebound to David Robinson. Robinson pounding himself back in shape. Marley with 6 points, three rebounds. Here's Hersey Hawkins from Bradley. Won't go. Slapped out of bounds.
That's the part of our game that I have a real concern with. The ability to consistently shoot the perimeter shot, which is so prevalent and dominant in international basketball.
Michael Adams handling the ball. John Thompson would like to have him on that Olympic team.
Oh, what a good look. What a great look by Patrick Ewing. Throws the ball diagonally, enters it into the hole. Mr. Thompson says, Patrick, can't you come and play with us in Seoul? He has really improved as an offensive player. There he is now looking the opposite way. The defense rotates over to the ball. They reverse it. Excellent play, looking away from the traffic. He really became a player offensively this year under Ricky Pitino. What a job he did with his development.
David Robinson inside committed the foul. David Robinson historically has made a lot of fouls in inside defense.
Well, there are a lot of question marks about David in terms of, is he physically tough enough to take the pounding? He showed it in 1986 when Lute Olson did a miraculous job and they won the gold medal, beating the Soviet Union in Sabonis. But remember, he hasn't played in competition for a year.
J.R. Reed in the ballgame now for the Olympians, working inside. Willie Anderson out of Georgia's in the ballgame. Mitch Richmond from Kansas State's in the ballgame. Vernell Coles puts it up and he is fouled.
Coles is an interesting story. He shot the lights out in a win for Virginia Tech against this man's team, Georgetown, John Thompson. Thompson remembered that, invited him to the trials, and he has really excelled. He's a guy that has great scoring ability, average better than 24 points a game, and he can really score with the rock. He's tremendous in transition.
Harold Presley has come in now, Sacramento Kings, for the NBA Stars. On the free throw line, number 24, Vernell Coles, Virginia Tech.
Harold Presley went to a wedding last night. He went to Rolly Massimino's son's wedding, and 2 weeks from now, Rolly's daughter's getting married. Rolly's going to spend some of that cash.
Harold's still getting over a cracked nose from the past NBA season. Back in a Patrick Ewing, Alvin Robertson, Chris Mullins, all members of that 1984 Olympic basketball team that didn't have the pleasure of playing the Soviets. Lord, I wish they had. That much could have whooped anybody, I think, anywhere in the world. A collection of people anywhere in the world. Terry Cummings brings it up now for the NBA Stars. He's picked off by number 24, Vernell Coles. Mullins on a drive. Mullins getting away from Mitch Richmond and takes it in. The Olympians have on the floor number 10, Willie Anderson. Number 4, Richmond out of Kansas State. Mitch. Now you see the setup with Coles handling the ball out in front. J.R. Reed, North Carolina's in there. David Robinson, Navy's in there. J.R. Reed wearing number 14. Robinson doesn't get it, gets the rebound, drags his pivot foot, gets away with it. Ball won't go down, and Terry Cummings comes out with it.
Oh, baby! What an explosive dunk from the baseline by Mr. Ewing.
Willie Anderson, who may very well wind up one of the point guards, takes it inside to David Robinson, and Robinson is held by Patrick Ewing.
Willie Anderson's a multi-dimensional player. He can play three positions on the floor. Didn't have a great senior year with UE Durham in Georgia this year. Had an outstanding junior season. We watched a replay. Michael Adams now throws the ball the length of the court. Look at Mr. Ewing with the clutch, the power dunk.
David Robinson misses the first of the free throws. Incidentally, in the international game, there is no protected cylinder. If the ball is laying on the rim, you can go up and stuff it through, or you can knock it off.
Yeah, you can play with the ball up there. You can, actually, what we call interference is permitted.
Ewing got it.
He took a little walking violation, even though they're allowed.
You get the extra step.
You're allowed one extra step in international basketball, but he took like two.
Ewing defending, slaps it away from David Robinson. Robinson just a fraction late getting back.
We take a look at Patrick Ewing right now. Watch. You're allowed one, two. He takes three, four. They can't allow that, Mr. Ewing.
Coles handling the ball. Checked by Adams. Look inside to Reed, back to Anderson out in front. That's Willie from Georgia. Mitch Richmond inside. It goes to number 15, David Robinson.
That was a strong move inside. He got the good angle on the drive. He has an excellent touch, David Robinson, and a tremendous shot blocker.
Adams pumps one, won't go down. And the rebound cleared by Anderson. Willie can sky. He'll fool you. He's stronger, perhaps, than he might look. Bouncing around, and there's a foul. J.R. Reed is fouled. If you're wondering, Dick, what John Thompson is trying to accomplish at this particular moment, this being the first of eight of these games, what is it?
Well, basically right now he's trying to find combinations. He's trying to find people that can flow well together. It's so important in assembling a team of this magnitude that you just do not pick the best players. Like, remember in 84, you and I were talking about it. Charles Barkley didn't make the team because he didn't fit into the kind of chemistry that the general, Bobby Knight, was looking for with this Olympic team, who, by the way, 84 to me, Keith, was the greatest team ever assembled for an Olympic basketball team. Some people say 1960, I take 84. Oh, there's Ewing, get got hit in the eye. This guy here is going to be some force with Charles Oakley. What a steal in New York by Al Bianchi. Getting Charles Oakley from Chicago to rebound, the Windex man, to join Mr. Ewing. Patino and Bianchi got to be on cloud nine.
All right, handling the ball out in front now is number 12, that's Sleepy Floyd, who played for John Thompson at Georgetown. And they turn it over now. And again, the Olympic team is not taking advantage of the official not handling the ball in the backcourt. That thing should be underneath the basket already, but they haven't done it yet.
They're not acclimated to it. The Soviet Union, you mentioned it yesterday at our staff meeting, they excel in that area.
So does Brazil and so does Spain.
Yugoslavia's got to be tough with it also.
Yep.
Yeah, don't forget our Italians, please. Don't forget my pizza makers, please, you, Mr. Jackson.
They can play. Handling the ball now, number 16, Charles Smith, the fourth.
The fourth.
David Robinson stays in. Willie Anderson stays in. Mitch Richmond stays in. J.R. Reed left, and Charles Smith of Pittsburgh came back, and Charles of Pitt has the ball. Charles Smith of Georgetown has it deflected a little bit and comes up with an air ball. Brad Lohaus of Iowa and Boston Celtics now in the lineup for the NBA stars. Inside, big Kevin Duckworth, 7-footer, 280 pounds, and he missed it.
And a very rich man. How much is a duck worth? You ready for this? He just signed a $16 million contract for 8 years.
Good move inside by Robinson.
Key to our team, David Robinson. The development of Robinson is so essential to the status of this basketball team. Can you imagine $16 million? I can't even envision that for 8 years.
Walking around,
Kevin
money,
Duckworth.
Dick. Walking around, money.
There's David along the baseline. Very quick inside. He challenges Duckworth and Lohaus and comes up with
ball
the deuce.
Ball comes loose. This is Richmond. Mitch puts it up. Won't get it.
They're allowing us to shoot the basketball. Notice how they're playing off. I keep saying us, talking about the Olympic team, but basically they're playing off. We take a look at the Olympic size, the trapezoid. As you can see along the baseline, it's a little bit wider in the lane than it is on the collegiate level, where it's 12 feet wide and 16 on the NBA level.
20.6, 20 feet 6 inches, plus a quarter, from the three-point line.
Switch up, switch out.
that's the black one in the middle. The white one's the NBA size. The one inside is the collegiate size.
What it does, it favors quicker players because it pushes your offense a little bit further out and takes your big people away from the lane.
Good move inside by Vernell Coles for the basket.
He knows how to score, Coles. He's got the mentality of a scorer. Hooks up with an outstanding guard at Virginia Tech by the name of Wally Lancaster, a transfer from Maryland. Watch a little physical play right here. Coles banging. Look at him pushing, grabbing. Gets thrown to the deck. I mean, he is really clawing.
Looks like he's played for the Italian.
Sent a message to Sleepy Floyd. I'm not going to be intimidated by you, Sleepy.
Well, they're going to let him bang because I'm sure John Thompson talked to the officials and said, let him bang. I mean, we've got a season. They got to get used to this. Coles moving with the ball. Marley back in the game out of the corner for three.
He can make the open shot. Jerry Colangelo's got to be smiling. There were some boos when Phoenix drafted Mr. Marley. There'll be no boos when he takes the floor. They will love him in Phoenix.
He has 9 points. The Olympians lead 24-11. Here we go from the Civic Center in Providence, Rhode Island. NBA select stars against the candidates for the U.S. Olympic team. Handling the ball out in front is Alvin Robertson, who was an Olympian himself in 84, being checked by Mitch Richmond. The Olympic team is on an 11-0 run right now. And we get a whistle and we get a foul. And men will go to the line or take it to the sideline. Will be Chuck Person. Chuck was an alternate on the U.S. Olympic team in 1984 out of Auburn. Ball is deflected, slapped out of bounds as Richmond now is endearing himself to John Thompson with that kind of defense.
They're going to love him down at Golden State because he's the kind of player Don Nelson likes, a guy that will play very physical, plays good, tough defense, and he can score, and he handles the ball a lot better, Richmond, than a lot of people believe. Sleepy Floyd, who's a scorer more than a point guard, down at Houston with the ball, playing in a corner with it. Man, look at that right there. He gets a tap on the head. John Thompson loves him. He will make our Olympic team. There's no doubt in my mind Dan Marley will make the 12-man roster.
Yeah, he belted Sleepy out of bounds, and John's up immediately calling for a walk. A couple of years ago, when Sleepy was playing for John, John would have been howling the other way. All right, handling it, that's Person. Ball is loose. Olympians steal it. And here comes Coles. Manning goes to the inside. Coles, drive it.
Good one-on-one play by Coles. But I think right there, John would rather see a guard able to break the defense down and get the ball to open people. We have some good one-on-one players with the ball, but we don't have the Isaiah Thomases and the Darnell Valentines who played on Dave Gavitt's 80 team.
All right, now the Olympians get the ball quickly and take it in. And a whistle and a foul as Robertson goes soaring into the air as Coles tried to get a quick one.
Alvin Robertson, one of the great defenders in the NBA, having a great career at San Antonio. There's a look at the Arkansas Razorback with the foul. We talked about it earlier, Keith. The transition game would favor the structured team and the team in condition. As we take a look from another angle, makes contact. Joe Forte with the call.
Team control fouls, no shots in international rules, FIBA rules.
We have to compliment these NBA players. They're all playing for nothing. They just basically get their expenses. Rod Thorne, vice president, to David Stern in the NBA office, has done a great job assembling these players. And I think they deserve a lot of credit for playing nationally like they're going to be doing all over the country.
There'll be a lot of different people, as we noted when we came on the air, playing. And that's going to be another foul on David Robinson.
Since David Gavitt started this back in 1980, the NBA people have only won one game as Brian Shaw comes on the floor. They've only won one game, and that was in 80. During 84, Bobby Knight's basketball team beat all the NBA All-Star teams. So there's a challenge for Michael Jordan and company. Come out and see if you can beat these guys.
Brian Shaw is out of Cal Santa Barbara. I guess Michael's going to play in one or both of the games scheduled down in Charlotte.
I heard everybody wants to play in one in Vegas. Yeah. Rod Thorne said he had about 50 guys, and we're coming down to Jerry Tartanian land down in Vegas.
Duckworth is on the line for the NBA select stars. 27-12 ball game.
I know you like this guy, Keith. All you big guys like each other.
Well, he's a real center. You know, he's Space Eater, what do you guys call him? Battleship?
Ooh, you're taking all my terms now. I like that. No, that's McGuire's tone. Now, please, you ruined my day. Use McGuire's tone.
I mean, Danny Manning, no, in the corner, but stealing the ball is... And giving it off is Hersey Hawkins, and the Olympians have the lead to 29-13.
Hawkins had a brilliant year at Bradley. Certainly will be a solid player hooking up with Maurice Cheeks at Philadelphia.
Little contact on that one.
Sleepy Floyd down the lane, changes hands, lays it on a glass, gets the deuce.
Manning, the man that stopped him with the physical contact.
There's the entry on him. Cut by Floyd, comes down the lane, takes the ball to his left hand, Manning makes the physical contact, Floyd gets the score. Floyd was criticized by Akeem the Dream Olajuwon up at Houston. Said he's not really passing the ball well. Sleepy is not a normal point guard. They're asking him to be something really that he's not. He's a scorer. In fact, one game, I guess it was a year ago, scored 30 in one quarter against the Los Angeles Lakers. This guy can score, put a lot of points on a board.
Jeff Grayer of Iowa State now has come into the ball game for the Olympians. Jeff handling the ball, number 20 right there, one of Johnny Orr's players. Robinson inside, double team, back to Grayer. He tries to get it back to David. And he does a little hopping as he is rattled around inside, and no foul, and here comes Sleepy. Into the corner for Lohouse. Inside Duckworth, 7-footer, 280 pounds, and he is hard to move, and he was fouled.
He's very quick inside. In the previous sequence, when David Robinson walked with the basketball, we saw the triangle that they like to establish offensively, the Olympic team. We saw the triangle with David down on the boxes and a wing player and a guy up on top of the key. He just couldn't come up with the loose ball. He got his great chance when Johnson was injured and Sam Bowie was injured. He took advantage of it. He went from about $175 per year to $2 million per year. And as you said, just a little pocket change.
Robinson handles on the sidelines. This is Jeff Grayer.
He's playing against a real physical guy, and Chuck Person, one of the cockiest guys in the NBA.
Ball slapped loose. Here comes Reggie Lewis of the Boston Celtics. Reggie puts it up after the exchange, and the ball is slapped out of bounds by Lohouse.
Jimmy Rogers figures that Lewis and Brad Lohouse both are going to get a lot of playing time this year to add a little depth to the Celtics, because last year they were a tired basketball team when the Pistons beat them in the semifinals.
Brian Shaw out in front. Grayer, top of the key, goes inside with it and gets it.
He's from out of Flint, Michigan, where they produce so many basketball players. This guy here had a great career for years. Johnny Orr, down at Iowa State country.
Time call, 9:44 to go in the first of two 20-minute halves being played between these two teams. The first of eight games they will play against each other. And the Olympians lead by 15. They were disagreeing as to what the score was, but our man, David Burnson, says he's got 31-16. That's what they find to put back up there. All right, here we go. David Robinson has the ball. Jeff Grayer looks at Hersey Hawkins, goes to him in the corner. Inside it is Charles Smith of Pittsburgh. And he won't get it. And the rebound comes out in a hurry for the NBA Select Stars, moving quickly with it. Reggie Lewis. Number 45, Chuck Person, doesn't get a good bounce, but inside, who was that? Lewis? Or was it?
Reggie Lewis. Nobody blocked him out. 25, Reggie Lewis from out of Northeastern. Played at Dunbar High School with the great players, guys like Reggie Williams, Michael Brown, who never really materialized, just became a very average player at Syracuse and Clemson, but then Tyrone Muggsy Bowles, David Wingate. Now Hawkins could score, Keith. He can flat out score. All you have to do is look at his numbers at Bradley.
You got to do more than score to make an Olympic team.
He's got to guard people, there's no question. Right.
Hustling on the play, Shaw. Out of Cal, Santa Barbara.
Celtics seem to be really excited about him. Jimmy Rogers believes that he can give him a little help. I know Jimmy's ecstatic with Reggie Lewis, said he was a man playing with boys at rookie camp.
Speaking of that, The oldest player we have on our Olympic, the oldest candidate is 23, right? I think the average player for European teams in particular is probably going to be 28, 27, 28. It's a little bit like where we send our boxers over. We send teenagers over to box against grown men. And to some degree, we're sending collegiate age people over to play against seasoned, mature men.
Don't get me started on that. I can't understand. We talked about it last night. The hypocrisy, the ludicrous that a Chris Evert, a Steffi Graf, and all the multimillionaires, Wayne Gretzky, is eligible to play in the Olympics, yet in basketball, we do not permit our best to play. I would like to see our dream team play in Seoul. Barkley at one forward, Larry Bird at the other, a guy in the middle by the name of Patrick Ewing, and a backcourt of Magic Johnson and Michael Jordan. Hey, I'm a purist. Traditionalist, and I believe in amateur sports. But if other countries are playing their pro athletes, then I got to believe we have to send our best.
Not that simple.
I know.
I'm going to talk to Dave Gavitt at halftime about it. You might be surprised at some of the things that he'll tell you. Here is Charles Smith, the Pittsburgh air ball outside, looking for three. David Robinson, incidentally, has now picked up his third foul. Stacey Augman, Alonzo Mourning, Todd Lichty, Elliott and King, Stacey King, have not played so far. Sean Elliott of Arizona, they have not played so far in the ballgame. That's Persons going to the basket, and Chuck gets it.
He's from out of Auburn, was rookie of the year. They booed him also when he was introduced by Donnie Walsh, the fine manager of the Pacers, on draft day, and they went out and became rookie of the year. Maybe that'll happen for Dan Morley with Phoenix.
Grayer handles the ball, loops it across. Brian Shaw inside. Smith gets the hook.
He's really been impressive in all their workouts. Charles Smith, I believe he's going to be a great force for Elgin Baylor and Gene Shue's L.A. Clippers, along with Manning and Gary Grant.
That's Shaw.
And he's a good one. He has to really improve his range as a shooter, but he has excellent instincts on the floor, and he's a tremendous passer.
You know what? The player he sort of reminds me of, remembering back over the years, this was not very long ago, in 84, Brian Shaw looks to me right now a lot like Alvin Robertson.
Well, that's a good comparison. Robertson's such a great defensive player. He's talking here. John Thompson said, I like what I see, Brian. A nice play. Now look at him. He pushes the ball up the court. Here he is now going to push the ball up the court. He's trying to look for the open people, but then takes the ball right to the goal. Nobody. See, no one communicates in the trail position. When you're a trail man, you have to let the guy know that's up in front with that ball that you're trailing the play. Look at this.
Not surprising.
No, they have to live off the turnover, too, because that's John Thompson's style. And by the way, I think Georgetown is going to be outstanding this year. When they throw Alonzo Mourning on with all their people returning. In fact, you ready for my top five preseason? I'll go 5, North Carolina. 4, I'll go with UNLV. 3, I'll go with Georgetown. 2, with Lou Henson's Illini. And 1, with Duke. Mike Krzyzewski's going crazy.
I wrote that down. I'll argue with you going home. Pool A and Pool B in the Olympic draw. You see the United States is in B with Spain, Brazil, Canada, China, Egypt. The Soviet Union over there with Yugoslavia. Australia getting a little better in basketball. And you never know about Puerto Rico. Remember in 1976 when they came within a point, Butch Lee and that bunch almost beat Dean Smith's team up at Montreal.
Player of the year that year in college basketball was a guy named Alfred Butch Lee.
That's right.
The
Whit Spain, Canada, Brazil. Are going to give the U.S. people their problem in their pool.
Well, a little problem. I think we'll get through that pool. I think the big concern will be the USSR, the Soviet Union, and Yugoslavia, who've really been impressive. But I think when it's all said and done, the gold medal will be around John Thompson and the American players. Too many athletes.
51 is back into the game, and number 33 is Patrick Ewing. Ewing can't get it to drop, but inside, Rodney McCray rebounds it, and a whistle and a foul. You're probably right. But you are not as close to being onto a sure thing as he was in 84, because the guys in 84 played on their home turf without the Eastern Bloc countries involved.
Yeah, you didn't have the Soviet Union as we watched a foul inside. McRae's a physical guy. A little pump fake, number 22. His brother Scooter McRae, now going to coach with Denny Crum at Louisville. I like
it's a different thing when you go wandering halfway around the world and your food's a little different, your circumstances are different, just the ambiance makes some difference.
Oh, there was a tremendous advantage playing on their home turf in L.A. in 84, and as you said earlier, assembling the likes of Michael Jordan, Wayman Tisdale, Patrick Ewing, Steve Alford, they had great balance, and they had excellent role players, as well as the star athlete who could break the game open in Jordan.
Now, that's a dribble too many that time, as number 21, Stacey King, had dribbled once already, and the ball is deflected. Here comes J.R. Reed just into the game. Back it goes from Shaw.
That's great two-man play. I'd like to show that a little bit later on a telestrator, but I'll tell you one thing. That's two-man play. Keep the ball a little wider than the lane, move the ball, and get the easy layup in transition.
Look at John. Deflected out of bounds. John Thompson setting his team.
Now watch them run off the steal. We said that this would have to be an important part of their offensive makeup. There's the little kick by Reed. Now he gets it right back. The power dunk by Mr. North Carolina, J.R. Reed.
Force that shot, air ball. Rodney McCray comes out with it, gives it to Michael Adams. Adams' shot is deflected by J.R. and out of bounds.
I think J.R. is going to improve in a few other areas. I think he had a very good year last year, but I still think he needs a little bit more improvement and playing a little bit outside the lane, being a better rebounder. For his physical size, his numbers rebounding aren't as good as they should be, and I think he just has to get a little bit more energy more consistently during the course of a game.
Inside, Chris Mullins steals one. The alley-oop does not exist in international basketball. Can't lob it in there. This is Jeff Greer bringing it up now.
I think that was put in to really try to negate the great athletes that we have in America.
No kidding. Greer loses. Reed picks it up. Ryan Shaw, Richmond. Inside it goes to Greer. Rolled off. Stacey King blocked out on the play. And this is Adams feeding McCray. Didn't get it.
They got to fill the lanes right here. See, we don't have the guy that can complete the play. 3-on-1, we should have had a layup right there. I keep sometimes saying we. I keep putting myself with the Americans. Please excuse me out there.
Where are you?
I guess. But really, they should have had the layup there in transition. I think all of us in America are part of the Olympic.
Of course we are. At least we're supposed to be.
Right.
Inside, Mullen steals it. Chris with a new haircut. McCray takes it down, grabbed and held and kept from falling there by J.R. Reed.
You know, very strong young man. You mentioned a new haircut by Mr. Mullen, but he also has a new attitude on life. After coming out of the alcohol rehabilitation, he has really gotten back to liking basketball again. It hasn't become a chore, and he's enjoying himself a lot more, and I hope and pray that he doesn't go back in any shape or form.
Let's look at the foul situation now for the Olympians. Robinson with three, Manning, Reed, Smith of Georgetown, Marley, all have two, so they're committing a lot of fouls.
Well, they have that physical style defensively that they play, the John Thompson system, and they're going to commit some personals. I think when you look right here, isn't this proof again the importance of coaching and organizing? I don't think anybody would disagree that if you can take a look, for example, at the talent that the NBA has, they have some awesome talent. But again, you're not going to get assembled in less than 24 hours and come out and challenge a group of talented young people and be able to, I don't think, get in a winner's circle.
Well, especially a game like this, Richmond tried to force it in to Stacey King. King's been in there now a couple of minutes and been very quiet.
See, they're not getting good angles, Keith. They're too close to each other. They're not getting that good angle on the entry to the post.
This is the first real game that they've had. They play the NBA guys 8 times total. Of course, the NBA people can play you one-on-one as well as anybody in the world.
What a funny-looking shot by Michael Adams, but the bottom line, he scores.
Richmond.
I don't think we've made an open jump shot from 17 feet. Oh, yeah, Marley made one. Watch this quickness. Now give it back to him, Chris. Thank you.
You're welcome. Marley's the only one who's hit a The only one who's hit a three-pointer, he's one for two outside.
There's Luigi Conaseca's boy, Mullen, kicks it off to Michael Adams. Two Big East guys. Adams scores and says, thank you, Mr. Mullen. He backed up John Bagley. Adams did when he played at Boston College, and Adams was a freshman, and they got a great guard right now, Dana Barros, who's one of the better guards in America at Boston College, another little guy who I think has a shot to make it in the NBA.
Willie Anderson in the backcourt now with Vernell Coles, J.R. Reed, Mitch Richmond, and Stacey King on the, no, Charles Smith now on the front line. The bigger Smith from Pittsburgh. NBA has had a 9-0 run, and they've got the ball again. It's 39-32 at that blinking scoreboard as the NBA stars are starting to close the gap a little bit on some careless ball handling by the Olympians. That's a pass that he gets away with only because it was deflected to his own man. You're going to see in the Olympics a lot of one-on-one play. The Soviets will play you one-on-one.
I really like the one-on-one ability of Coles. He is really a lot better than I even anticipated, the kid from Virginia Tech. One reason why they've closed the gap, Keith, they've done a better job now, the NBA people, getting back in transition. Just look at John Thompson.
Well, you're looking at a minute ago, wondering what that is on Harold Presley's face. I told you a while ago, he's still getting over a broken, cracked nose.
Yeah, he had an operation. He told us he had an operation.
Yeah.
You know, looking at John Thompson previously, I really believe this, and I don't want to offend people, but I think you take, for example, the programs at Indiana, programs at North Carolina, at Kentucky, they will go on without a Dean Smith or a Bobby Knight as they're in a bonus right now.
Alonzo Mourning is in the game. He's got a ripple through the crowd.
Oh, yeah, Alonzo got in here. But you take a look at Georgetown. If John Thompson were ever to resign at Georgetown, I believe that program goes absolutely to nowhere land. That's how big of stature he is, and I don't mean just physically. I mean in terms of what he's achieved at Georgetown University. An amazing job he has done there.
J.R. Reed getting a couple of free throws, and that makes it 42-32. And we have 3 minutes and 28 seconds to play in the first half. The Olympians on top by 11.
Key, take a look right here. We have J.R. Reed in a situation where we're going to... trying to get this telestrator to work, but it's not working right now. We can't get it working, but basically we're showing a two-on-one. They attack Michael Adams. They stay a little bit wider than the lane. The key is that they stay a little bit wider than the lane to force one guy to have to try to defend two, and we get the layup. Turnover right there on the telestrator. Give it a big T.O. Turnover.
I sabotaged it. Michael Adams up in front court for the NBA. J.R. Reed picks him up. Inside, they take it. Oh, that's a pretty good defensive play by Mr. Mitch Richmond, huh?
That showed the makeup of the defense of John Thompson, the great help defense. They show fronting Ewing and then bringing the weak side help over, the help side, and they got three people surrounding him. Excellent play defensively, Mr. Richmond.
6'4", 222, he takes on Ewing and wins.
He's a linebacker, as you say. Hey, I know you can't wait for September 10th, Nebraska and UCLA. UCLA in the win column, that great quarterback.
Troy Aikman.
Oh, he's a tremendous player.
He'll be a fair to Midland scuffle, I'd say. Inside, ball to Richmond, slap loose. Olympians keep it. They lead 43-34 by 9 right now. They're by 15 at one point.
Richmond going out to Golden State. They're going to move Chris Mullen to the small forward position and play Richmond. But the key for that team will be whether Ralph Sampson ever becomes the dominator or will he be a soft player. If he's soft, as he's been in his pro career, they will go nowhere at Golden State.
There's a foul. As Vernell Cole wiggled in, found some daylight. I would imagine, I know that Bobby Knight did it in 84. I know Dean did it in 76. And Dave Gavitt did it in 80 when they were playing this series of games. But you'll see the NBA players will try to cooperate with the Olympic coach in executing different kinds of pressures occasionally during the course of the ball game. Try to force them to do different things.
I'm sure they're conversing with one another, trying to get them to play in certain situations, a certain style of play.
Vernell Coles now with 10 points. That makes him the top scorer among the Olympians. 11 now. See the pressure.
There's John Thompson, former Providence player, 1963. Led him to an NIT championship under Joe Mullaney, 64, to their first NCAA tournament.
travel call inside there. Turn it over.
See, they're trying to beat him up the court. That's that international rule. Official doesn't have to handle the ball. I like that rule. I like to see it be utilized here in college basketball.
It'd stop a lot of the squawking and beefing, wouldn't it?
Yeah, because the player would have to get back defensively instead of moaning and groaning to the official.
That's Willie Anderson handling. That's Richmond.
Well, it's some physical force going inside with Reed and Cummings. Give it up.
Ended the pass for Mourning. Didn't work for him, and the NBA comes storming back to score. So Alonzo Mourning has been quiet since coming into the game. JR, like a tight end going downfield, hauls it in. And in heavy traffic, Mourning loses the ball. He's only 18.
See, the rhythm offensively is not there right now in the five-man game for the Olympic team. And that's going to happen when you're changing lineups.
Anderson is fouled by Presley.
You know, you mentioned Dave Gavitt a little bit earlier. We're in Providence. 1980 had quite a team assembled that never got a chance to play in the Olympics, with Isaiah Thomas and Darnell Valentine at the point. Sam Bowie up front, a big guy, Lister, an intimidator coming out of the collegiate ranks of Arizona State, Rolando Blackman, Mark Aguirre. That was one great team, and Gavitt had a tremendous coaching staff with D. Rowe and a guy by the name of Larry Brown.
And look at the Women's Olympic basketball trial camp. There's rumors going around that I'm not going to confirm because I don't know if they're true. We can't get anybody out there to answer the phone. But we did hear of an injury in their training session, but we absolutely confirm it. There's the power of young Alonzo Mourning right there.
What a force he will be in the Big East, along with Billy Owens, who's a mini version. Yeah, John's sweating a little bit, but you're not going to sweat. The opposing coach is going to sweat, John, that has to deal with this young man. Alonzo will arrive in Hoya Land.
Todd Lichty of Stanford has now come into the ball game.
I don't believe Alonzo will make this team. My feeling is they have just too many experienced people up front, but he's getting a great, great deal of experience just competing with these people.
Mullen hooks it off to Ewing, and Patrick is fouled.
Now, think about this for a freshman also coming into college. He would have to miss a great deal of the early part of the semester at Georgetown, one of the great academic institutions in America, as we watch Mourning. He's taking it up against a former Hoyer. He freezes him. Patrick, you left something on the floor. You left something on the floor, Patrick. But I don't believe that right now Alonzo probably is as schooled and is as ready as some of these experienced people and will not make this team. That's just my gut feeling. I've been wrong before, Mr. Jackson.
Well, he's had a goodly bit of seasoning already.
Oh, he sent home some NBA first-rounders at the trials, like guys like Ronnie Cicely and Will Perdue and Eric Lechner, and he shipped those guys right home, those big people, at the early trials.
Ogman and Sean Elliott have not played so far in this game. Rolls handling the ball out in front. Todd Lichty in for the first time in the game, coming up on 1 minute to go in the first half.
He's a tough kid. Todd Lichty can make the big play. Stanford's going to be really a good basketball team. The Pac-10 is really going to be improved this year.
Ewing gave JR a whack in the mouth with his elbow, and Michael Adams saves it, and they take it down inside, and it's going to be foul down there. Played at Oak Tree in Edmond, Oklahoma. And if you ain't played Oak Tree, you have missed something.
Ooh. Look at this, little football time. The Dolphins and the Redskins. Are the Redskins for real, or was that just a fluke last year?
That's
you
Denver.
Said that. He has Denver. Denver's got Tony Dorsett now, though.
9 point, 49-40. If I can read that winking and blinking scoreboard with less than a minute to go. Coming up on a half a minute is Lichty. Is being checked by Chris Mullen. Todd from Stanford. And handling the ball outside. Good shooter outside. This is Willie Anderson, Hugh Durham's player out of Georgia, throws it away. And Michael Adams, who played at BC, comes up with it. Boy, do they like this little guy in Denver.
Oh, ooh, Doug Moe loves him. He is so quick, and he can really shoot the three-point shot.
Inside, good move, Terry Cummings. It's 10 seconds to go in the first half.
What a force he was for Ray Meyer and the great DePaul teams. They were number one in the nation, and then they got beat by UCLA 1 year, and 1 year by St. Joe's and Jimmy Lynam.
And The half is over. And at halftime, it's the Olympic candidates, 49. NBA select stars, 42. Coca-Cola presents the U.S. Olympic trials. Back after this commercial message, a word from your local station. The score is 49-42 for the Olympians at the Civic Center in Providence, the first of eight times that these teams will be playing, not in the all-together because the NBA people will be changing some as the schedule goes along. And it's the final days of struggle for the Olympians, the candidates, 17 now, who will be cut to 12 by September 2nd. If you remember at the Winter Games in Calgary, which you watched here on ABC Sports earlier this year, there were professional hockey players playing in the Olympics and competing under national flags. Immediately after the games, they went back to their National Hockey League team. Coming up in the Summer Games in Korea, you have professional tennis players with millions in the bank who are going to be playing tennis for a medal in the Olympic Games. All right, the question then is obvious. Why not Larry and Magic on the U.S. Olympic basketball team? Let's turn now to Dave Gavitt, who's the commissioner of the Big East Conference, who is the chairman of the Games Committee for Men, who's been involved in Olympic basketball for many years, who is well-schooled in it as much as anybody in the country. Dave, my question to you is, why not Larry and Magic on our Olympic basketball team?
Keith, I'm not sure what's going to happen, but as we sit here today looking ahead at what's going on in the international game, it would not surprise me that this will be the last time that professional players, as we know them, NBA players, are not eligible to play. There's a meeting upcoming in Barcelona, Spain, of FIBA in April of 1989, and from my personal vantage point, I think the votes are there with the other countries. I think there's a lot of conversation that has to be held and will be held in this country among all the various constituents. My own personal viewpoint is that the NBA guys should be permitted to represent their country. If every other country can use their best players, and many of these guys are being paid a lot more than NBA rookies, then why can't our best players represent our country? Well, and I think that's where we're heading. And I think the proof that it can work are these games. The NBA, David Stern, Larry Fleischer, the Players Association, people like Jimmy Rogers, and all these players who have come out here to give of their time to help our team prepare. I think that lends evidence to the fact that the amateur game and the professional game in this country, if forced to, can and will coexist.
Is it not true, though, Dave, in times past, the United States itself has voted against professionals participating?
Well, the United States and the Soviet Union have voted together against it the last couple of times, Keith. And I don't want to be premature. I don't think that some of the amateur people in this country would share my views or share my opinion. But I think that the votes are there in the rest of the world, and I think that that you'll find that this is not going to be a fight over who wears the tuxedo at the track meet. I think you'll find people will be reasonable on both sides, both the NBA side and the college and junior college and high school side. And I believe in the not-too-distant future, in my lifetime and yours, we'll see it happen.
Of course, we may run into the same old problem that we have seen surface before, where an NBA franchise might do like the NHL franchise said, so wait a minute, he's too valuable. He ain't going up there and let some check whack him upside the head.
Well, I think, you know, what's going to be important is that everybody's a co and equal partner in this. If we're going to have a basketball federation that's going to be different than the one we have today, and the NBA people are going to be in it, we need good, responsible NBA people, and we have those. We've had great help from people like Wayne Embry and Pete Newell over the past 12 years. We need to sit down and make sure that the same standards of performance that have brought us the gold so many times before are that we hold to. We're not going to have agents picking our teams, and you're going to go out there and make it on what you do on the court.
Dave, it's refreshing. Thank you very much for the information.
Enjoyed seeing you, Keith.
Dave Gavitt, this sort of a Providence reunion. Providence man, John Thompson, Providence man. We've got a lot of Providence folks around here today in the old city. Having fun? Score is 49-42, Olympians, and we'll have a look at what's happening with the women's Olympic basketball program in their training camp in a moment. Well, adding to the story about the women's basketball camp, as you see the score here in Providence at halftime, the Olympians leading. We understand that Cheryl Miller, in a scrimmage Friday night, sprained her right knee. That is the knee on which she had the surgery. And it was a pretty good-sized reconstruction job on it. So right now, Cheryl Miller is simply on a day-to-day basis. Could miss.
We'll be back after this commercial message and a word from your local station. Well, we're ready to go with the second half of play. The Olympians are leading by 7 at halftime. Some of the stats in that first half may be revealing to you, even though this is the first really public outing for the Olympic team.
Well, the USA team only shot 46%. I think the big stat is the fact points off turnovers, getting 13 points off turnovers. Individually, I thought the play of Dan Marley, he was very impressive early, and also Coles. Coles did a good job of penetrating, getting some scores, scored 11 points from out of Virginia Tech and Central Michigan's Dan Marley, showing you that you don't have to be the big super name to be able to play with all the big guys.
All right, let's set the lineups for you. Mitch Richmond is out there for the Olympians. David Robinson. Marley just stole it. Loose pass coming down court, and Marley was right there. Danny Manning is on the floor to start the second half. And Charles Smith, the point guard out of Georgetown. For the Olympians, it's Sleepy Floyd handling the ball there, and Ex-Hoya. And up goes the shot. From number 25, who is that? Reggie Lewis, another former Georgetown player.
No, he's from out of Northeastern.
Northeastern, I'm sorry. And Brad Lohaus of Iowa just made the bucket, and he was fouled. So it gives me a chance to set the lineup. Kevin Duckworth of the Portland Trailblazers on the court. Sleepy Floyd is out there. Brad Lohaus, Chuck Person, Reggie Lewis. Now, for the Olympians, it's Charles Smith at point guard. On the front line, it's David Robinson, Dan Marley, and Danny Manning with Mitch Richmond teaming up at the other guard spot with Smith. This has a look about it, this lineup for the Olympians, doesn't it?
It does have a little look in terms of it has a point guard with Charles Smith, even though he thinks score. Marley is one of those complimentary players who really is so tough physically.
Gives it up for the shot along the baseline that won't go down for Richmond.
Richmond, a pretty good baseline shooter, shot the eyes out and sent Gene Katie's Purdue team to the sideline for Kansas State's basketball team.
Duckworth didn't use all of his 280 pounds that time to open a hole.
He's an amazing story from out of Eastern Illinois University. A lot of people didn't give him a chance, was traded by San Antonio, where he was an all-bench player, and now has become a real million-dollar player.
That's Danny Manning with that little jump hook that he perfected at Kansas, and that time he wouldn't go down for it.
I like this guy, Danny Marley. Watch the anticipation right here. Now, Marley's going to step in, make the steal. Good anticipation, number 18. There he is with the steal, and now he gets the easy layup. He has really been starring since postseason play. Had a lot of injuries throughout his collegiate career, back, ankle injuries. But what a tough competitor.
Lohaus takes it inside. Robinson got a piece of it. Duckworth has it. And he walks with it.
Jesse Thompson with the call. There you are, pushing the ball up the court. International rules. Official doesn't have to handle it in the backcourt.
Three-pointer for Charles Smith. He got it.
He can do that. Came off the bench, time in and time out last year for Georgetown. Finally, at the end of the year, he started, played a lot of minutes, and now here he is battling himself to a spot on the U.S. Olympic team.
Chuck Person. Robinson has the ricochet rebound, gives it away to Charles Smith.
See, David has a tendency to play a little bit like a forward at times rather than a center inside.
Loose ball retained by the Olympians. Manning will take the opening, give it away to Richmond. Blocked by Duckworth. Lohaus to Floyd, one man defending.
Give it up.
Marley.
They don't look to give it up too much in transition. He had the quick bounce pass to Lohaus for a layup, but Floyd takes it in, and he does score.
Well, the NBA guys ain't the problem. They ain't the project. The project is the fellas in blue.
They're not the guys you're trying to reconstruct or restructure.
Robinson.
See, he wants to play outside a little bit on a perimeter, and he does have forward skills. He's so quick, he's agile, he's mobile. He's got to get a little bit more hostile.
Yep. If you don't go in and take up space in Seoul, Korea, you're liable to come home with something that doesn't gleam yellow.
I agree with
to you about Richmond. I really like him. He is just a real fierce guy on the floor. He's going to the sideline right now, and Todd Lickey's coming in for him. Mike Montgomery's done an outstanding job at Stanford, bringing about a real stop. Their program, they could be top 20 in the nation next year.
Good pass to
Lohau. Nice play.
Duckworth asserting himself. Back up. And there's a foul.
You know who looks really good out there for the NBA team, and he hasn't really scored? Number 44, Brad Lohau. He's showing good quickness. He's a seven-footer who can pass the ball. He can also shoot the ball from the perimeter. There he is, Tom Davis's former athlete with Iowa, number 44. He'll get a lot of playing time this year with the sophomore.
Danny Manning got three fouls now. So he and David Robinson both have three. It's a 58-50 ball game with the Olympians leading.
They're hanging in there. What a great story Jimmy Rogers is, coaching the NBA team, the new head coach of the Boston Celtics. He coached at the University of North Dakota under Bill Fitch, became the head coach there, and then finally went with Bill Fitch with the Cavaliers.
Oh, that's
a violation. And look, now he's getting his chance finally with the Celtics. And I'll tell you one thing, he has paid his dues.
Robinson has it, bad pass. Didn't get the clearance pass out. But Smith saves it, misses the three-point try, and goes soaring up into the seat, saving the ball.
I think it's obvious that the Olympic team is not ready yet for the gold. These exhibition games are going to help them really mature the team, give them playing time experience, because they're not ready right now to win the gold medal. There's too many weak links, especially in the way they play on that perimeter offensively.
It's now a four-point ball game, 58-54 after that three-pointer. Well, John Thompson said that we're just now starting to try to play together, and the Soviets have played 111 games together.
I think also reducing the squad, Keith, so you can get the good minutes for the people that really are going to be part of the 12-man troop that's going to Seoul.
Danny Manning now with 7 points in the ball game.
I think they're a little excited down there in Clipperland. I wonder if all those Hollywood stars, Jack Nicholson, will divorce now the Lakers and run over and get a courtside seat with the Clippers.
Got to get softer seats at the sports arena. 6-point lead for the Olympians. 3 Central Time, Saturday, August 20, on ABC's Wide World of Sports.
That's a two-shot foul because you fouled him before the ball was released from the sideline. He'll go to the line and get two right now. Trying to get a little physical defensively. Look at that, Charlie Smith. I mean, he's mugging Floyd. He's saying, Floyd, I'm not afraid of you. I'm not afraid of you. You know, John Thompson's assembled a staff that consists of people that he's very comfortable with. He has Mary Fenlon, for example, who handles all the academics administratively at Georgetown as his administrative assistant. George Raveling sitting next to him, who was an assistant coach to Bobby Knight in 84 on his left. And on the right of the screen, Billy Stein sitting next to him was a former assistant coach at Georgetown, now the athletic director at St. Peter's. So the important thing for John Thompson was he wanted to develop a staff that he was comfortable with.
Sleepy Floyd makes a couple. You know why he took Charles Smith out of the ballgame just now? You know, Charles was still upset over the double dribble that he got caught with back there. He's been fuming about that ever since he committed that error. Vernell Coles is back into the lineup for the Olympians. Marley has the ball. Charles Smith is inside along with David Robinson and Todd Lichty handling it outside. Alvin Robertson checking him, and Alvin Robertson's about as tough a checker as you're going to find. And here come the Olympians on defense. Marley back in a hurry, but the ball is stolen by Charles Smith to Pittsburgh. And Vernell Coles to David Robinson tries to reverse it in a foul.
You mentioned that combination, Charles Smith and David Robinson. That duo played a real important role in the United States winning the gold medal in 1986 in Spain under Lute Olsen. Smith was brilliant, was the leading scorer for that team. We watch a little transition basketball right now. They push the ball up the court. Look at Robinson running the court. He can run like a deer. The one thing about the kid, he's got superb quickness.
He has 8 points, 0 for 3, now 1 for 4 from the foul line.
You know, he's another one of those great stories that you don't have to be a high school superstar. When he came out of high school, he was hardly recruited by anyone. Went to the Naval Academy and made himself into a big star under Paul Evans, who's now at Pittsburgh.
Nature Health, he grew to 7 feet.
Yeah, nice pass.
Great play, Robinson.
Yeah, that's where he'll excel defensively.
Sean Elliott is in the ball game for the first time today out of the University of Arizona. Stacy Augman now is the one remaining player who has not been in the game.
There's David Robinson with the left hand rejecting the shot. See, he gets the great angle with the left hand. If he uses the right hand, he would create a foul situation. But he comes over, he's a left-handed player. It seems that all your great shot blockers are lefty. Bill Russell was lefty, because remember, most people shoot with the right hand.
All right, Elliott back in the backcourt now with Coles, and Sean bringing it up.
Not played well in the practices. Sean Elliott has not played to his potential, according to people on the inside.
Elliott runs down the rebound and comes away with it as Lichty misses, and now Coles comes out to help a little bit.
I'll tell you what, you wouldn't find a better small forward in America than Sean Elliott.
I think so. But he missed now. He missed that shot. Pressure comes in funny ways on different folks, doesn't it? Look at this. Danny Manning fights for and comes out with it.
He'll make the pass.
Survives that collision. And then missed the little feed from Coles. Alvin Robertson.
I really like him, Keith.
Oh,
I really like Robertson.
Great player. Great fella. Air ball. There.
He's not really a good shooter, and he'll be the first to tell you he's really a guy with great athletic ability. Played for Eddie Sutton at Arkansas, and you talk about a guy facing some pressure right now, Mr. Sutton down at Kentucky.
Charles Smith handling the ball against Brad Lohaus, pulls up and fires and gets it.
He's balled
down 64. I think that's 64-56.
Charles Smith is multi-dimensional. He's the Eastern version of Danny Manning. He's so versatile. Has a strong drive by Floyd. Has the rotation defensively. And they get the contact. They get the little push right out here. There's the contact. Joe Forte with the call. Forte's leaving the ACC along with four other officials to go to the NBA. Getting some big bucks. And college basketball is going to miss Joe Forte. One of the premier officials in the college game.
That was the first foul on Coles in the ball game. Presley comes in now for the NBA stars. And Rodney McRae is back in. Patrick Ewing is back in. Harry Cummings. For the Olympians, it's Jeff Grayer. Danny Manning. Charles Smith of Pittsburgh. Sean Elliott of Arizona. Darnell Coles of Virginia Tech. Once the ball, remember, as I told you, hits that rim, you can go after it. There's no cylinder, there's no protection in international rules. Coles misses one, gets it back, has this one blocked out of bounds.
We look at John Thompson taking a real study, analyzing, evaluating what he sees on the floor. The basic thing we talked about a little bit earlier, Keith, that he's looking for, he's trying to find combinations. He's trying to find people that blend well together and can play the game together.
Well, you see Charles Smith getting hammered inside. So we'll have another walk to the foul line here with the 12 minutes and 46 seconds to play in the ballgame.
They have to cut down to 12 by September 2nd, but I really believe he'll do that before then so he can give the players some experience and develop the rotations he would like. So I would think within a week you'll see a couple of people chopped off the squad.
Yeah, I think you'll see probably after the third... trials game, exhibition game, you'll probably see them go to at least 14, which will be your 12 plus the alternates.
I think right now, when you know, people ask you everywhere you go, I've all these writers, Dick, try to pick the team. It's only a guessing game. And you certainly right now, they're going to take a look at these games, developing it. But I think a kid like Alonzo Mourning will not make it.
Pressure there defensively. Charles Smith gets the basket off the steal, and this is the kind of play that can drive you nuts. That this group in there right now is quick.
See, that's their style of play. Use the great pressure defense. That's the style of Georgetown. Not that Alonzo's not good enough. I just don't think physically and emotionally and mentally that he has the experience that some of these other people have. And that's the reason that I don't think they'll make it. There, take a look at the defensive pressure. See, that's going to be their great asset. Athletic ability, quickness, getting to the basketball really quick.
The exhibition series will pick up again August 12 in Charlotte and again August 14 in Charlotte. I would think after those two, you'll probably get a serious cut. In effect, John can cut three, and he's got his working unit.
Two guys that I was really disappointed did not come to the trials, Gary Grant of Michigan and Tim Perry of Temple. I thought they both had a great shot to make this team.
That's Grayer hitting that one.
Chuck Grayer could shoot the open jump shot. Milwaukee's going to like him. Their coach is here today, Del Harris, and he's going to be excited to have Grayer in a Milwaukee uniform.
City. They have really suffered up there this year, and it's a hot, muggy weekend back here in the East. 70 to what is that? 70 to 58? Guessing.
I know that scoreboard is something else.
Inside, Elliott didn't come away clean with it.
The game of basketball is so much, really a lot of timing and rhythm, and the timing and rhythm is not there yet for the Olympic team, but that is to be expected.
Terry Cummings won't get it. Danny Manning had it. Cummings stripped it. Grayer picked it up, and they're running 3-on-2. Now 3-on.
Oh, what a play! Showtime! Party time! Mr. Danny Manning! Wow!
Woo! There's one thing about this series that I remember so vividly from 84 is the NBA guys play with not a lot of emotion, but when you see something like this, that gets in the craw of the big pro.
And right there,
he comes right back down and says, in your face, baby.
Oh, I like that, Keith.
Coca-Cola presents the U.S. Olympic trials. We'll continue after this message.
One eye is going bananas. One eye can't take it anymore.
Sean Elliott, David Robinson, Vernell Coles, Danny Manning, and Jeff Grayer, the lineup for the Olympians. Rodney McCray picks up Elliott, and the ball comes loose. Sean trying to force it, got a little bit out of control, and Grayer comes back to steal it from Terry Cummings.
Based on what I've seen thus far, want my starting five? If I go with starting five, want to get? No, I'll pick John Thompson's team. What the heck? Have a little fun. Coles, I like at the point. I like Richmond as second guard. I'll go up front with Smith, Robinson, and Manning.
Into the crowd, hurdles the sphere, and they'll retreat it.
You like that club?
Get on.
Clubs.
The two players that seem to jump at me right now, though, is probably not going to stay around much longer with the Tom Lichty and Sean Elliott.
Yeah, I really believe Elliott is struggling. I definitely feel, according to the reports I got, it's not going to be Lock City for Sean making the Olympic team, and Todd Lichty as well. Alonzo Mourning, I don't feel, will make it.
No, he's
Brian Shaw,
the third one.
I think Brian Shaw could be in trouble also.
And it'll come down. He'll wind up in the alternate process. Chuck Person was an alternate in 84. Outside, Chris Mullins.
Oh, what a velvet touch. How I remember that shot. 1985, the Big East celebrated with Villanova, Georgetown, St. John's in the Final Four. Almost had four teams. Gary Williams' team was beaten at the buzzer by Andre Turner in the semifinals of the region at Memphis State, where there possibly could have been four Big East teams in the Final Four. He walked right there. Don't want to get hurt here. Ricky Pitino and Al Bianchi are jumping out of their seat wherever they're watching. They said, I don't want to see my big guy get hurt. They will have Madison Square Garden rocking and rolling. Mr. Ewing and Charles Oakley. Oakley is the Windex man. He just cleans the glass. Michael Jordan's going to miss him in Chicago in terms of getting the ball out and getting their transition game going.
David Robinson picked up his fourth foul on that play. This Charles Smith of Pittsburgh comes in and Robinson goes out.
This guy went to the Final Four 3 years out of the four at Georgetown. Won it in 84 when they destroyed Kentucky in a semifinal and then beat a team to dream, Olajuwon, and Houston in a final up at Seattle.
Dan Marley has come back for the Olympians.
You like him, Keith?
Yes, I do.
I really like Marley. I just like what he does on a floor. He's got range as a shooter. He'll defend you. He'll play very physical basketball. And he is not intimidated by the big mega names. He has proven that he belongs with all these giants. Internationally, you can step in as soon as they, anytime practically. Right. There is no, like in college basketball, you can't step in until the shooter releases
some of the sharpest elbows in the world are thrown on the free throw line in the Olympic Games. It's Marley. He had his three-pointer but didn't take it. Inside Manny. Smith almost muscled it up.
Charles Smith, very quick inside. They're going to have quite a duo. Smith and Manning are going to excite a lot of people. They may not win out of the gate because the key to that basketball team with the Clippers will be Benoit Benjamin if he ever, ever lives up to his potential.
Coles, I think in this particular outing, it's been relatively impressive. He looked pretty solid to me.
He can score, Keith. The question mark is, can he make the pass? Oh, nice drive right there. Have a true legitimate point guard that thinks pass first and shot second. All of these guys are scoring basically on a collegiate level. Charles Smith, Coles, and Willie Anderson. There's the big fella, the heavyweight champ. I want to see him take on Mike Tyson. What a battle. Tyson and Thompson for the title. Look at that drive down the lane. There comes the help. Ewing rotates over, checks the ball to get fouled on a play.
Patrick now has four fouls.
Remember, internationally, you get five. That's six like in the NBA.
But you have 17 fouls, and if you are fouled outside in the three-point area while taking a shot, you get three free throws.
Grayer came out of Flint, played with Glenn Rice, who's going to make one of my top 10 players in America from Michigan. Bill Frieda, loaded again. Stop crying, Frieda. You're loaded. You got so much talent up there. Mills and Ramil Robinson and Rice and Sean Higgins. He's always crying, Keith. He and Boeheim are the biggest criers in the history of basketball. They have so much talent, but I love both guys. I love to tease them, and I'll continue to tease them.
Shaw is in the ball game now for the Olympians. That's Manning out in front.
Ooh.
That's not goaltending, under the international rules. Ewing, the man that knocked it away, and that'll be a travel as Michael Adams got a little bit out of control. Don't have to touch it on the turnover in backcourt. There was nobody there because Marley had it out of bounds, was ready to wing it. But Ewing, remembering the Olympic rules, was back in a hurry.
Little screen and go away. That's part of their offense. Pass and go away from the ball. Nice look.
Pretty good check inside. Balls then ricochets off Manning's knee out of bounds. Time remaining, 8 minutes.
Mullen. Nice, strong drive. You know, everybody's saying that he's going to have a tough time defending people at the small forward position where you face the great athletes, but they're going to have a tough time stopping him as well. And if Sampson really gives him the kind of play inside that he can protect Mullen on that baseline, I think he's more exposed on a perimeter defensively than he would be on that baseline.
Out of the corner, Jeff Grayer out of Iowa State nails. One down and runs the score to 76-68 now. And Terry Cummings answers with a nice move.
Jeff Grayer, another kid that knows how to play the game and just has that mentality, who knows how to score. I know Larry Brown loved him in that Big 8 conference. He just rants and raves about Grayer in a very positive way.
Brian Shaw. Out in front, Manning. This is Shaw.
That's the one rap on Brian Shaw, shooting the rock. Well, what a pass by Manning. Always looking for the open man. Very unselfish. So talented, Danny Manning.
Jesse Thompson calls timeout. with 7 minutes and 12 seconds.
We're going to take a look here at Danny Marley reversing the ball to Danny Manning at the top of the key. And then Manning is going to find the open man. This is ball reversal. Watch Marley swing the ball. Now here comes Manning. Now he freezes the defender with the head fake and then finds the open man. And Shaw has the wide open jumper off the glass. The telestrator was working, Keith. Hurrah, hurrah, hurrah.
Now will you put it back to bed? Reggie Lewis is in the lineup now for the NBA All-Stars. That is short off the iron. Marley goes up to get it and then loses on the secondary effort to big Kevin Duckworth. And that ball's going to be off.
See, another area that you have to be a little concerned about, and you've alluded to it so many times and talking to us up at the meeting since you were involved in 84, physical play. And right now, you're a little bit soft across the front. Yeah. When you talk Manning and Smith and Robinson, who's going to take the physical pounding of those players internationally who want to beat on you constantly? So therefore, you beat them with quickness.
Right. Well, and Elliott comes back now, and Marley goes out for the Olympians. Remember, there was Ewing, there was Tisdale.
You had Konkak. You had some physical people.
Big folks. Sean Elliott stands in there pretty well at 6'7". They list him at 196, but I tell you, he didn't look it.
I love Sean Elliott. I'll tell you one thing. They could be mighty proud of him down in Arizona. He's such a team player, great attitude, an All-American in every way.
That's a foul on Chuck Person there, shoving Elliott back over the line. And we're at 6 minutes and 20 to play in a ball game, and the Olympians are leading by 8 points.
I was teasing Chuck before the game. I said, Chuck, they tell me that you're overrated. I love to get on him. He looked at all the young kids with stretching. He says, hey, I don't know what you cats are going to get, but I'm going to get my 30. And I said, come on, be easy. I'll tell you one thing, he scares Dominique Wilkins. Dominique, don't get mad at me, but he runs those words on Dominique and frustrates him when he plays against him. And then Dominique gets about 35 off him and laughs at him. I'm only teasing.
Long pass to Charles Smith. Slapped out of there. You can do it. It's legal. But Sean Elliott retrieves. No, that's Brian Shaw retrieves and scores it.
You can play. That was an example of interfering with the ball. This guy is tough. I'll tell you, he's a man. When he wants to play, Mr. Person is a man. M-A-N. And this man is a winner. I can't spell winner. Take a look right here. This is permitted internationally. Watch when the ball gets up on the rim, above the cylinder. You can go up there and you can get this baby. There it is. He takes it right off Alvin Robertson, just sweeps it away.
Coles back in. Mugged in the corner, and the ball is knocked away.
He's not a true point guard, Keith. What we, the definition of a point guard, somebody that can break defenses down, read the defense, he is a scorer. All you have to do is look at his numbers at Virginia Tech.
Lohouse inside to Reggie Lewis.
Two Celtics hook it up, and Jimmy Rogers smiles on the sideline because they're going to get some minutes this year. Rogers' philosophy, as we look at Jimmy along with Chris Ford, who should thank me every day because I put him in that Celtics sideline when we traded him in Detroit for a guy named Earl Tatum. When I received a phone call from a guy named McGuire, the guy conned me, said, Dick, you can coach Mr. Tatum. Make that trade. I made that trade, and I got fired. And I became the guy to really get on everybody's nerves and get on TV.
All right, Elliott coming up with it. Person after him, double-teamed at midcourt. Sean works his way the hard way. Marley back in, over to Coles, got a shot. See, he thinks scoring.
Another glammed in by Charles Smith. Mr. Smith is going to be a force on the Olympic team. Not just a player, he's going to be a force.
That's Duckworth, 280-pounder. Here comes Marley, loses control of the ball, and the NBA Stars will return it.
See, it's interesting to see who's on the floor now late in the game.
Yeah, it is, isn't it?
Smith and Manning. There's Smith handling the ball.
They're Greyhounds, though. There's not a muscle team, is it?
No, it's a team with quickness. They have to rely on their agility and their great mobility.
Second clock. Harley forces it up as time is running down on him.
Look at Lojas. I really like his ability.
Danny Manning, foul.
Watch Charles Smith now. He reads it. Good offensive rebound. Good extension right over the top of Lojas. Gets the conversion. Gets the deuce. From out of Bridgeport, Connecticut. A lot of people were brokenhearted that he didn't stay in his state and go to the University of Connecticut. Jim Calhoun's keeping him there now. He's building a great program at Connecticut. Yeah, Smith with 12 points, 6 rebounds, 5 assists, 2 blocks.
Not bad.
Not bad day. Good second round selection. Arnold Red Auerbach, always one step ahead of most people. Mr. NBA, when you talk about a guy that is the father of the league, I talk about Mr. Auerbach for what he's achieved. And he is, along with Dean Smith, two guys that have played a great role in the mind of John Thompson. In his development as a coach and as a person, he credits Mr. Auerbach and also Dean Smith. He was an assistant to Dean on a 1976 team, and everybody knows what I think of Dean Smith. A dumb Michelangelo or coach.
It's a 5-point basketball game now as Manning goes in, gives to Robinson. David Powell will go to the line.
I know, I guess we can't read into the pattern of play as to how many minutes guys have played, but J.R. Reed certainly hasn't gotten a lot of playing time today. Ewing fouled out of the game.
Yeah.
There's a lot of concern about the Admiral David Robinson. A lot of concern because of the fact that many people feel that he's just not up to his par that he was a year ago. But you have to remember, this kid didn't have a chance to play in the kind of competition that's needed to really sharpen your game. But he's such a competitor, so intelligent, and he just has the great size and stature. And I just think that when it's all said and done, he's going to be a positive force on that baseline.
At 3 minutes and 48 seconds to play in the game, 83-77. We've got a crowd
going to the Big Bundle in the seniors' most prestigious tournament. I watched yesterday, Walt Zimbriski made 7 on that little 17th hole, 151 yards downhill, hit it in the water twice. Oh, me.
That's weak to me, Keith. I don't understand that little white ball, what they do banging it. Hey, people are wondering why Ewing's on the floor. 5 fouls is all you're allowed international basketball, but they decided to let the guys play. 6 the limit today.
That's sort of a mixture of rules anyway, because of the way they're working it out. And right now, you've got a 84-79, if that's correct, or 78 ball game. I can't read the bloody scoreboard. The only person on the Olympic team not to play today has been Stacy Augman.
And he's got a great chance to make the team, so don't look into that because of his defensive ability.
They use pretty good coming outside hunting those three-point shooters. Elliott. And it won't go for Charles Smith. Inside, however, Elliott keeps it alive for Manning.
Great look by Sean Elliott. Elliott finds the open Manning. Manning converts it. Not a good shot by Charles Smith. Hey, right now, I'm going to tell you something. These NBA guys want to win. Don't think they don't want to win.
It's now 86-81, 5-point ball game.
Notice John's philosophy now. He's allowing Manning to play the backcourt. He's saying, okay, man-to-man defense now. You adjust by putting your big man on Danny Manning. Danny Manning is a gifted ball handler. He gives you an extra dimension on the floor. He gives you another passer at all times, similar to Larry Bird with the Celtics.
Marley got loose.
John Thompson loves Dan Marley.
This is Terry Cumming. Marley took the hit.
Yeah, I was just going to say, look who took the hit. Dan Marley scores on one end. John Thompson applauds him, and then Marley comes back and he squares up defensively. Oh, I don't know about squaring up. You might have got away with one right there. You might have got away with one, Mr. Marley.
Should have been a block. Not a good call.
Only in this country.
Right.
Sean Elliott handling the ball at about a minute and a half to go now in the ball game.
See, he's so versatile. He can play anywhere, point guard, second guard. He's got good skills, one-on-one with the ball.
And he is held. Nope.
I don't know what was the ball there.
I think time probably ran out on him. Chris Mullin here against Marley. Ewing against Robinson. Loses it. Robinson picked him, and Elliott will bring it up.
So now they got to play intelligent. They're not playing really intelligent at the end of the game when winning time's at stake.
Mullen misses. Robinson rebounds. The Olympic trials presented by Coca-Cola, an ABC Sports exclusive, being brought to you by your local Coca-Cola bottler and Coca-Cola Classic, the official soft drink of summer. By the heartbeat of America, today's Chevrolet. By AT&T, the right choice. And by Bartles and James Premium Wine Cooler Company at 101 to play in the game.
John Thompson reading the riot act during the TO, during that timeout, about the time. He looked up at the scoreboard. He's watching the same scoreboard. The kids probably said, we can't understand the scoreboard. He's going bananas and wild. Look at John looking up at it. He said, it was never like that when I played here at Providence. But being intelligent at the end of the game is so important. Keith, the three-point shot has been a non-factor. That's what we've been looking at all day here.
Right.
And I really worry about that, especially when you think about the international teams that run, and when they run a transition game to Soviet Union, they run to score three, not to get two.
Well, now, I watched some of that. In fact, I saw some of all three of the games that they played against the quote Atlanta Hawks. Of course, it was only a few of the Hawks, mind you, but Dominique was there, Livingston was there, Spud was there, Doc Rivers, and the Soviets looked to me like at times that they wanted to take it home against Atlanta just to prove to themselves that they could take it in there and slam it and slam it and slam it. And
I was surprised they played the Hawks as tough as they did. And they could have possibly, as John said, won every one of those games. They played the Hawks.
Why were you surprised?
I didn't think they'd play the Hawks that well. I really didn't. I thought the athletic ability of a Dominic, if you look, Mary Finland to the left is the academic advisor, and that's Stacey Augment. It was now called the Big West. They emulated, as we were talking last night, Chris Plonsky of the Big East. They are now calling it the Big West out there instead of the PCAA. I just thought the athletic ability of the Hawks would have prevailed in bigger numbers.
Yeah, but you only had a few of the Hawks.
Yeah, the conditions, too. The conditions.
Yeah, sure, of course. They're in between tourism and strange food and hotels. It makes sense.
Fratello couldn't get any Managotti, any rigatoni, Mike Fratello to eat. And that really hurt him in his philosophy with his team.
Yes. 56 seconds to play in the game. The leading scorers for the Olympians right now, Marley with 13, Coles 11, Manning 11, Smith 12, that's Smith out of Pittsburgh, Charles, and Robinson with 10.
Here's the other rule that's prevalent internationally. You have an option to take the ball out of bounds or shoot the free throws. You can do that throughout the entire course of the game, not just at the end of the game. They decide to get clock now and to take the ball out of bounds and use the clock.
Leading by 7 points, and
spread the court.
40 seconds now.
It's sloppy. You don't want to spin and turn in traffic. See, that's the area I keep talking about. Where is the point guard?
Where's dribbling?
They don't have a guy that can really handle it and run the offense.
Marley knocked it loose. Manning scores it on the pass from Charles Smith.
See, that's what they have to rely on, the steal, the layup, and transition. I really believe we can be hurt late in the game if we have a close game because of a lack of the stability that a point guard can give a team. You say, what is a point guard? He's an extension of that man, an extension of the coach. He can read the defenses. He can recognize what's happening and doing the proper things late in the game.
Well, now, somebody brought up a point in visiting here over the last few hours that if John Thompson so chooses, he can recall.
Mm-hmm. He can what now?
Recall.
Oh, you can recall
a player?
I didn't know that. That's interesting. I guess you can right now because he has until September 2nd to announce his team. Yeah, he can do that.
Rodney McRae at the line with 15 seconds to play in the ballgame.
I could understand Gary Grant, who told me so many times I wanted to be part of the Olympic team, then not deciding to go to the Olympic trials.
Getting a little ragged.
Yeah,
here
really
in the closing seconds.
Not playing well late in the game. Not really making the good plays. Oh, John's got time. He had to piece this team together. He and George Raveling and Billy Stein will get back to the X's and O's, take these players, find the combinations, find the people that can help them to get that W, get that gold medal.
Augman is finally into the ball game with 13 seconds to play. John probably didn't, somebody didn't realize that Stacy hadn't played. Had a rebound to Charles Smith.
Michael Adams had him by the britches, caused him to walk and got away with it.
Hey, Stacy's supposed to be a great defender. He'll get a chance to show his defensive ability when John will put him one-on-one with Mr. Michael Jordan.
Three-pointer, no. Rebound, no. And Danny Manning muscles it out of there. The game is over. So the Olympians win their first of eight against the NBA Select All-Stars. Final score, 90-82. Coming up next.